remember as a little girl, my grandmother, we called her Mamaw, she would have sent home a couple of jars of Chow Chow every year, and we really like to eat those with our field peas and any kind of beans, really. And so I make her recipe, and we enjoy it on New Year's Day with our southern dinner of greens and field peas and cornbread, and I just like that really sweet and vinegar flavor with some beans. So when you start going through your green tomatoes, you'll want to check and make sure there's none that have soft spots or brown spots, anything like that. You'll discard those if you find any. Make sure that you get your green tomatoes off of healthy plants. And so we'll just cut that down into some manageable size for the food processor. And I've already washed all of my vegetables that I'm going to can, but I am going to peel off the outside leaves of the cabbage and also cut it down for the food processor. My grandmother would use a variety of peppers, I think probably whatever she had. So I'm using some red, I'm using a little green, and I did not have hot peppers, but I did add red pepper flakes to my seasoning for the brine. And then we'll use some onions as well. I'm just using a regular yellow onion, and I'm going to process all these down until you get about a texture like this. Nothing too fine, but that's about what I remember. I also remember little chunks of green tomato in her Chow Chow, and I'm sure that wasn't intentional. I don't think that she had a food processor. She probably did it in a blender, and perhaps it did not blend down all of the green tomatoes, so maybe the core. So there were little chunks, and so I'm just going to do that in keeping with the texture that I remember, but of course you don't have to do that. That's just for my memories. And so I am going to go ahead and combine all of the vegetables in just a little bowl there and add 1 cup of pickling salt and combine everything. I'll cover it with ice and let it set out overnight covered. And then the next morning I'm going to go ahead and combine all of the briny ingredients, which is basically the vinegar and some water, a lot of sugar, and the seasonings. And again, I am adding a little bit of red pepper flakes to this, which was not in her original recipe, but that's because I didn't have hot peppers at this time. And this is not an instructional video on canning, so I suggest that you either take a class like I did several years ago on canning, or just make sure that you are doing it properly and follow all safety procedures when you're canning anything. Okay, so we're going to heat that up. We're going to stir it and heat it up for about 5 minutes. And once you've done that, then you can fill your already warmed canning jars. And you always put warm vegetables or warm food into warm jars so that you don't crack your jar. Also, we'll force out the air of anything that you're canning. This was just some pickles that I was doing, but I wanted to show you how I force the air out with a plastic utensil or a skewer. And then we clean off the rims of the canning jars so that we get a good seal. And then put your warmed lid on there. And then hand tighten it, and then come back just a little bit so the air can be forced out of the jar. And then we're going to top off the jars with some hot water that I had on the stove also, and measure for 1 inch of water over the cans, and process it for 10 minutes on a high boil. Once it's processed for 10 minutes, you can remove the lid, turn off the heat, and then time it for 5 more minutes. After 5 minutes, you can begin to remove your jars. And I know it's tempting at this point to tilt the jar to get the water off the top, but please don't do that because you could break the seal. Okay, just leave the water on top of your jars, and we'll cover them up with a towel. We'll let them sit out until you hear a little popping sound. And then you know that they are sealing. The next morning, I will remove the ring and give it a label, and then I can enjoy it on New Year's Day. And I hope you're able to try this. Thanks so much for watching. Have a beautiful day.
Undertaker.